Namaste, welcome to tummy.com, a platform for yoga teachers and teachers in training. Today we will be discussing the peak pose sequence for Hanumanasana or the splits pose. The purpose of this video is to help yoga teachers create peak pose sequences with confidence. So we will take you through the sequence that we have created for Hanumanasana, where we will talk about points to keep in mind while sequence building, how to break down the sequence, how each pose helps the students for the peak pose. So by the end of the video, teachers can create new sequences for the same Hanumanasana, but with a different set of poses. We have used the tummy.com sequence builder to create this sequence. Before we begin, few points to keep in mind is that in a peak pose, we first need to identify which are the muscles and parts of the body that are engaged. So in Hanumanasana, the hips, glutes, hamstrings and the pelvic region is engaged. This is at the physical level. Many poses also works in the minds of the students. As Hanumanasana is fairly a difficult pose, it is important that the students are constantly reminded to have faith and patience in themselves along with constant practice. We will be showing how poses work at physical level as well as at the mental level of students. This video is divided into three parts consisting of warm-up sections, various sets of standing asanas, followed by sitting asanas, supine position asanas, the peak pose and the cool down asanas. So let us begin. Now in the warm up section, we have included sun salutation B or Surya Namaskar B. Why did we include this? That is because besides having asanas like warrior pose, which works on the hips of the students, it is a rigorous warm up which opens all the muscles of the body and also works on the endurance of the students. And this is very important for a peak pose like Hanumanasana. We have included two rounds, but the teachers can judge the flexibility of students and decide the number of rounds they would like in their flow. So the first pose is the intense leg stretch pose. This works on the hips, glutes and hamstrings of the students. But at the same time, because it's a forward bending pose, it works on the stability and balance of the students, which helps them for the peak pose. In Hanumanasana also, the students need to have a sense of balance while entering into it smoothly, which this pose helps them to. The next two poses is the downward facing dog and the three-leg downward facing dog. Both of these are great asanas for hips, hamstrings and the spine, which will help students in their flexibility and strengthening needed for the peak pose. The next pose is Parshvottanasana, which gives an intense stretch in their hamstrings. It takes the minds of the students towards their alignment, which is a crucial aspect of Hanumanasana. Students understand the control they have over their body, and that is important as a yoga student. There are variations to this pose, which the teachers can use depending upon the level, the ability of the students. The next pose is the humble warrior pose. Now, as the name suggests, it is not only a great hip opener, it works on the humility of the students also. It teaches the students to surrender themselves, and that is exactly what Hanumanasana demands for. We introduce this for students to understand the connection between the mind and the body. Similarly, teacher can add other poses that works this way. The next asana, that is the low lunge pose and its variation winged dragon, both open the hip region and help in opening the inner thighs, which in turn help the students for the peak pose. At the same time, both these poses works on the breathing cycle of the students. It helps them to get into the practice of breathing in rhythm, and this will help the students to hold Hanumanasana for a longer period of time. The next pose, that is the half splits pose or Ardha Hanumanasana, is a preparatory pose. Here students will understand the level of flexibility they have in their hip region. Even here teachers can add the variations, use of props, so it becomes easy for students. The last standing pose is the half pigeon pose, which you enter into from a three-leg downward face dog. Now this is quite similar to Hanumanasana, as it gives the same feeling when Hanumanasana is done, because in both poses the perineum comes in contact with the ground. So as you see in a half pigeon pose, the perineum is in contact with the ground. Similarly in Hanumanasana also, the perineum comes in contact with the ground. So if the student can achieve this pose, it's a major confidence booster. Now as you saw, the various poses that have been included until now are on the basis of which parts of the body it works on and also how it affects the minds of the students. The poses need to add up to the practice of the peak pose. As teachers, we have to judge the capabilities of our students, introduce variations, use of props and build a practice. Next two videos will talk about the next set of asanas and why they have been included. So stay tuned and thank you.